a threesome, you know, my threesome. So, all right, so let's move on to the second question. What's your ideal Valentine's date? Because, you know, Valentine's is Sunday, which, what, that's it, 2-3 days? So what is your ideal Valentine's date? Whitney, are you there? Okay, we'll come back to Whitney. Keke, what is your ideal Valentine's date? I think you're the only one up here that might have an actual Valentine. This year?
Well, I hope not. Oh, this year? Well, this year. I absolutely hope not.
What do you mean? We don't have Valentine. Because, I mean, Daniel got
know. Team. You might have somebody.
No, I don't.
I mean, somebody might be pressuring on somebody.
You know, you got to do your gig.
Oh.
You said what?
I said somebody might be crushing on somebody. I mean, I have a secret admirer somewhere and just get something out the blue. Like, you never know.
Oh, yeah. I have plenty of people that secretly admire me, but you know.
Really, Daniel? But
they try.
So my ideal date. I'm not a person that's like big on something that has to be like huge and expensive and all that stuff. Like I'll take it if you do it, but it's the little things that kind of count for me. So the little things, an ideal day for me could be like as far as like he owns a restaurant. So
we're talking hypothetically, correct?
Right. So like to actually set up dinner at one of the tables at his business. Like, you don't have to like go out and buy all this stuff or like just do like $100 in a date. Like, I'll take steak and shrimp and at the table at your business. I'll take a picnic on the tailgate of a truck. I don't know if y'all remember that little thing that was going around on Facebook where he had fried chicken and fries and the candles, and they were on the back of the pickup truck, and it said, and the question asked, ladies, would you take this as a date? And my thing is, I would. Like, it was not, it was a candlelight dinner. I don't care if it was like fried chicken or what. Like,
okay.
I'm just simple like that. As long as I can tell your heart was put into it or your thought was put into it, then, you know, I don't really have like a picture, but just something, I don't know the right word I'm looking for, but something that's more homey, I guess, kind of, I don't know. Cortney, help me with my word.
I get what you're saying.
I get what you're saying, but I can't think of a word that you want to say.
Daniel, what about you? What's your ideal Valentine date? If you had one, or it could be from previous Valentines, like what you actually did, or it could be where you at in this moment, in this space in your life. Like, how would you treat your girl or someone you would be interested in?
So I'm a bit of a hopeless romantic. So for me, it would be more so my ideal would be if the weather permits, I'm really big on picnics. One of the things that I always do is I try to pay attention in the relationship. So if there's something that I always see you with, your favorite snacks, your favorite drinks, your favorite food, I'm gonna put all that in the picnic basket. You know, you're not going to know it's a picnic. I'm going to try my best to coordinate to have you meet me at this location. It'll already be set up. All you have to do is just follow the balloons or follow the rose petals or something like that. And, you know, just we'll have a picnic together if the weather permits.
Okay. Cortney?
I don't have an ideal perfect date. I don't.
I don't know what you're gonna say.
Like, huh?
I said, how did I know you was going to say that?
Because I don't have favorites or nothing like that. My thing, I guess, I'm more of the same thing of what Kesta was saying. Like, as long as there's effort put into it, you know, I guess. But I mean, like, I don't know. I'm good with dinner and a movie. Like, I'm okay with that. I'd rather not do, like, maybe something so typical. Maybe that is the most I can say, is I'd rather not do, like, the typical thing. However, like, I don't have an ideal date.
I don't necessarily have an ideal as well. But I'm big on, like I told y'all previously, I'm a great gift giver and whatnot. I don't really have an ideal date myself, but I can say what I would do for my guy if I had one at the moment, which I thought I was going to have one for this Valentine. And let me tell you, because like I said, I'm a great gift giver. So, and I pay attention. So in December, right? In December, I had already started planning the guy that I wanted to be with. I already had his gift, like, custom. I was having his gift custom. And D'Andrea, my Facebook friend, D, she know, because whenever I need something, like, customized or something, like, handmade, I contact her, right? She's all the way in Georgia, but she does fabulous work. Y'all need to, go visit her. Matter of fact, let me find her on page while I'm talking. But this the guy. So, you know, a lot of guys, he's a sneakerhead. Her name's D'Andrea Williams on Facebook. It's D apostrophe A-N-D-R-I-A Williams. And in quotation, she got a D baby. But listen, he's a sneakerhead like most guys. And I have found this thing. It was like a Nike shoe rack kind of sort of, but it was made of like wood, I guess you could say. And so I knew he had like a lot of shoes. And so I contacted my girl. I'm low-key embarrassed, but fuck it. That's I got it. You know, I'm built like that. I'm cut like that. So in December, I was like, I sent her the thing. I said, hey, listen, I'm talking to a guy right now. If he good, then I want this made. Can you do this? And so I was like, I know he's gonna have more than like 10 pair of shoes. So can you do it for me? And so I was thinking, I said, kind of make it tall like a dresser. Because what it was like more floor model. It had like two levels, a bottom level and a top level. And then it had like a top on it that says Nike. I'm pretty sure y'all probably saw it like floating around the internet or whatever. But it was like a Nike box, and then it would automatically open it, and it had like lights and stuff in it or whatever. So I was like, can you make me a tall one like a dresser? And so she was like, what she could do and what she can't do. But it didn't even last that long. Like, the guy just so full of S. And I was like, I messaged her back. I hit her back maybe like a week later. I said, you know what? That custom Valentine's gift for that guy, don't even worry about it. She didn't even stress she didn't even stress me about it. She said, damn. She said, all right. But yeah, I goes in for like the guys that I like. Like, I pay attention, like what Daniel said, I pay attention to the stuff that they like. I try to make life easier for them, you know. But I would do something like that for a guy, like for him. But for me, I'm simple. I don't need much. I'm Southern. I'm born and raised in South Carolina. So I really don't need much. You could probably get me like some turtles, like the, like what Russell Stovers used to have, like those little.
I like turtles.
Oh, girl, I love them. Like those little clusters of candy with the caramel and the pecans or peanuts in them. That, I love Reese's Cups. Turtles with candy?
Hmm? Yeah, candy. I thought those were actual
turtles.
Oh hell no! I don't do
that.
Oh god, girl, I'm scared of animals. Well, no,
you've never had those.
Oh, they're amazing. What else? I'm not a flower girl. I kind of, guys kind of make me feel, well, Keke trying to make me feel like I should be a flower girl. She kind of make me feel, we're probably gonna have a therapy session. She tried to make me feel like I'm less of a woman if I don't accept flowers, but I don't care about flowers. If anything, give me edible arrangements. Give me fruit that's shaped like flowers. Like, I could do more with that. You know what I'm saying?
That's a good alternative. I mean, you don't want flowers, but you like
fruit and shape like
that's flowers. That's good. That's right. Good.
I, like I'm not a sneakerhead, but I always tell guys, because the guys that I usually deal with, they are sneakerheads. So I said, whatever you get me, I'm an 8.5, I'm a 9. No, I'm a 10 in girls and a 9 in guys. For anybody that's, you know, want to surprise. But I said, but colors. I love colors. Like, clearly y'all know, if y'all watch me, y'all follow me, like, my hair is always like a different color. Like, I love colors, you know. So long as it got like a lot of colors in it, then I'm cool with it, you know. If you had to get me shoes, because guys don't really know how to shop for women other than like shoes or something, you know. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Like, and if we go into like a room, I just need a hot tub. Like, give me a hot tub. I'm hot tub shouting. Like, give me a hot tub. You know. And other than that, I'm good. You know, give me some money. I'm always with money.
See, that's the thing. I suck at gifts. I hate when it's time to give gifts.
Do you?
Really?
I'm a pretty good gift giver. You know, like,
I'm so quick to be like, here's some money, go buy your own gift.
Cortney, that is
no,
so
no, Cortney, I hate that. I hate when people tell me, know, like, they me only want money.
I hate it too. Don't get me wrong. No. It's like way out. There's no thought into it. There's nothing. But because I suck at gifts, it's too much. I'm really horrible at gifts. I'm horrible.
I think I'm pretty good at gifts.
Tell me what you want.
No, Cortney, let me help you out real quick. For people who are listening, who's like Court, because there are a lot of people that's like her, that just, here you go, you know, this is what you do. And it's still giving money, but it's putting thought into it. And it's so simple. Instead of giving cash money and say, hey, go get what you want, you already know the person. So the foods that they eat, because one of the
oh, no, like, I'll do it in gift card form. I'm not
do that.
I'll do it in gift card form. I'm just saying, like, I'll be like, I know you like Nike, so I'm going to give you a Nike gift card and be like.
Right, yeah.
But, I mean, it's still a cop-out when you really think
yeah,
about
it is, because that gift cards kind of go not hand-to-hand. It's a little bit better than just giving them money. Because it's just like, okay, I really didn't know. I know you could use shoes. I'm going to get you shoes. Or I know you love to eat. Anybody wants to eat. And if you don't have to pay for it, it's even better. So I think it's like cash. I mean, cash is not bad, but it's like almost like you weren't thoughtful in a gift. And then it's like gift cards, and then it's thoughtful things. And I like thoughtful things. Like, I want to be...
Me too.
I want you to, like, remember something I told you that I wanted to do or something that I like. And then it's just like, boom, you just popped up with it. Like, those are, like, the best gifts to receive. And I don't know if y'all already talked about all y'all ideal dates, but I want to talk about mine.
No, this is what we're on that topic now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Did everybody already go?
Yeah. I was stalling for you.
Oh, okay. Okay. Thank you. Okay. So I had some technical difficulties, but I had, like, in my background, it was like this couple and they was on a picnic. Y'all, I've never been on a picnic with somebody. Like, picnics are like the best. Like, I would say like a candlelit picnic would probably be ideal, just because, one, I've never been on a picnic date like that before, and plus I feel like it's a different feel. Like, it's more romantic than just going out to a restaurant. Like, I mean, going out to restaurants are cool. I mean, if it's a really good restaurant, then you can probably get away with that. But, you know, something different, like, we could still go out but create like a different environment. I think that would be something that would make it more memorable and you know, a lot better than just, you know, just going out to eat anywhere.
You know what? I'm low-key embarrassed.
Why?
Because he didn't deserve it. but it just lets me know. No, he didn't. But the people that know about this, they're probably gonna be laughing that if they're watching. But you know, with last year 2020, with social distancing and COVID and everything, a lot of stuff was floating on the internet, like how to redo things, like rekindle things. Like, a lot of people that wasn't using their backyards prior to COVID, prior to staying in the house, quarantining and stuff, social distancing. So now people were turning their backyards into romantic places.
Oh, that would be so neat.
So I was doing a lot of conversing and dating, COVID dating, quarantine dating and stuff, like during last year. And stuff. And so it was a guy, you know, we was talking on the phone for about a month and a half, 2 months before we like finally met up. And so you know, I packed the lunch. Like, I was gonna do the picnic thing. Like, I was gonna do that. we was going fishing. Like, I already had fishing poles and stuff, whatever. But I went out and bought, like, real bait, worms.
You brought out all the stuff. Okay.
Listen, I packed stuff up in a little, you know, little cooler and stuff. Like, listen, it was going to be amazing. And he didn't even know. Like, I was going to surprise him with that. Mm-hmm. But fast forward story, he didn't deserve it. But I'm willing to do those type of things. So when you say the picnic, yeah. Like when you say you've never done that, I was close. I was, and it was in the daytime. So
I want a fancy picnic though. I want like a, you know, I want to have my wooden basket and I want to have, basket. I want to have that's on fast. The night. I want it to be nice weather so I can have on a nice little sundress and I can just have my hair just, that's you know, fast, flowing, that's breeze, that's all that good jazz.
okay. I hope everybody's taking notes, you know. So like, does it matter, like, because you said candles, so when the sun is almost going down, like, you know, or you know, I guess nighttime would be pretty.
Either or really. I mean, it can be when the sun is out, I feel like that's fine, or I feel like it's of course only candlelit if it's, you know, the sun's already going down and it's more of the vibe, but I'd be perfectly fine with one like during the day, like that would still be
would you still want it if it's cold? No. What if like
now we can do something rooftop related if it's, you know, cool, something like rooftop or
when it's cold,
huh?
Closer to the sky when it's cold.
I want to go to the mountains. Like, I'm so mad at 2020. Like, I went shopping. I bought like a coat. Like, I'm supposed to be going to the mountains. I'm supposed to be doing a lot of stuff. Like,
I wanted to go to Colorado. I want to go to Aspen.
We're supposed to be going to Tennessee or whatever the crap was.
Oh, Tennessee's good.
I'm going this year. Like, hopefully, I ain't gonna say I ain't gonna go, but hopefully, I
should have a girls trip in the mountains.
Well, I was gonna do that anyway. I was gonna do like a little retreat for us or whatever anyway, but you know,
we can get matching pajamas, y'all.
Oh my gosh, yes, I'd be so excited for that.
We can go live, like do an episode, like you said, Court, like do an episode like actually in person. Everybody's in the same room,
right? Yeah. Oh, that would be good. Yeah, I like it.
All right, so let's go to the third question. And y'all can also drop in the comment section like y'all ideal Valentine date. Or if y'all already got something planned already, you know, you can drop that down in there.
All right. Dan says she loves a picnic. So we have, another picnic person.
Yeah.
Well, that's what I had said too. What my ideal was a picnic.
You said that?
Yeah.
Yeah, he said that. Is it a picnic because we've been seeing it on social media? Or
No. I've never had the opportunity to go on a picnic. I've never had the opportunity to take anybody on a picnic or actually go on a picnic. But like, that's just the softness in me, like the hopeless romantic in me. I think it's really romantic to just think of all her favorite foods. You're paying attention to her, not asking her, so what are your favorite foods? Like, no, I see you always have hot Cheetos all the time, so here's a bag of hot Cheetos. You know what I'm saying? In the old school wooden basket with a nice blanket.
See, you gotta have a basket.
And see, I was gonna get the basket, but that shit was like $85 and I was
it's expensive. Dude.
Walmart got one for $25 and it's this big and I was about to buy that thing. It was this tall.
Wow.
And it's, it's like old school woven and it's so nice. I was gonna buy it. I was gonna take this girl on a picnic, but like you said, she ain't deserve it. Just like your you know what I'm saying? It just didn't happen.
Yeah, like the one that I saw, it was expensive, like, but it came with everything. Like it had like nice silverware, it had a nice little blanket, it had like cups and stuff, like you know, to
put things.
And, it was nice, but I was like $85. I got a cooler. I got a cooler and I got Tupperware.
Not Tupperware.
Yeah. And I had a little throw blanket, you know. But all right. So question number three, unrealistic pressures